Notes. Hardcore's regulations demand I file a report. I find this difficult to imagine due to the unexplained outcome of events, which occurred on Alexis Sinclair's island fortress. All of the U4 has been seized, and Syntech's key employees are in custody. Alexis's body was not recovered from the island, and the evidence I found regarding Syntech's quantum destabilizing technology forces me to assume that Alexis Sinclair, the self-proclaimed Mother Nature, has simply vanished without a trace. Status: unsolved. Note: while the immediate threat to civilian life has been averted, and all parties involved are currently awaiting prosecution, I will still continue my investigation into Miss Sinclair's disappearance. Some part of me won't let it go. I know she's still alive, and when she resurfaces, I will be there. Colonel J.R. Blade, Hardcore.
And I think that's it.
It's the sound of refreshment, John Blade style.
Ah! Help! Somebody get this! Ah! Blade has lost his mind. Get animal control down here, quick.
Look at those little legs run. Get back here, boy. Come and get a whooping.
Yeah, and you get to see, that's the end. That's the end of Sin. Get to see the ending and all the people that worked on this game. The art department. Well, what an ending. I just hope that perhaps we call it that. Programming Mark Dochtermann. You know him because I talked to him about him in the start. And Charlie Wiederholt. Also a famous name. The level lord also. He was on the left. Yes, all the you made a fantastic job, people that worked on this game. Yeah. Music, all tracks written by Zach Police. Okay, obviously I now have to make a comparison to Half-Life because after all, this game was directly meant as a competitor to Half-Life. Okay, there, Hannah Logan was the voice of Alexis Sinclair. She was really good. Also, the other people made a good job, I think. Yes, it. I'm afraid that Sin was not as good as Half-Life. And there's a picture of a woman. Very nice. She's. I'm afraid that Sin was not quite as good as Half-Life. I mean, history is already spoken. It's judgment basically, but I think it was still a great game. It made so much fun, and especially in the first two episodes, you could see how much fun I was having playing this game. It did had a lot of new things, like the idea that actions in your game change the way it sort of have consequences in later levels. That was implemented quite nicely. Yes, also things like consoles that you can use and hit zones. So depending on which zone you hit, you could have a different effect, and you could also punch weapons out of the hands of your enemy, and also they could punch out new weapon, I think. Didn't get to see that so much, but yes, it had a lot of innovations. A lot of innovation through the first-person shooter genre that were later reused, like this in Deus Ex. The thing about consequences of your actions, long-term consequences. So it was a great game. I think one mistake that them was to put it in a competition with Half-Life and to rush it out. That, I think, was a really... Because this game felt a bit not unfinished, but unpolished. There were some rough edges, like cutscenes where the music was much louder than the person speaking and so on. Things that could have been changed really easily, but were not, because I think it was just rushed. I think this game would have been better received if they would not have rushed it, just taking a few months. It would have come out a few months later, but it wouldn't have made such a big difference. Yeah, but it This game was totally forgotten. And this was undeserved. I mean, this is undeserved. There you can see the development team again on the left. It was certainly one of the shooters that you have to remember if you grew up in the 90s. It is far superior to Quake 2. I will play the sequel to Sin, or the expansion. It's not a sequel, it's an expansion, Wages of Sin. I will play it at some point in time. Not yet, but eventually. And I will also play Quake 2. Eventually, just so that you can see how much better this game is. Yeah, we have had an absolute blast making this game. I bet you did. I've waited so long to play this game, and I was not disappointed. Quite the contrary, I didn't believe it would be so good. Major bug detected. Ritual offices, there's a fridge without Diet Coke. Okay. Devastating. Okay, little inside joke there. Even though, considering the fact that there were many bugs in this game when it came out, that is actually not so funny. Reproduce. Enter the ritual. Yeah, that's quite funny. Okay. My time has run up. I hope this video does not go over time, but I don't fucking care. Fuck you, Google. I will keep this recording as long as the cutscene closing credits are. Okay, and there are some more people that are being thanked. Some with not with real names, but with pseudonyms. Okay, they were bug testers, I suppose, or... Okay, that was it, okay. So, there's nothing more to say. This game was awesome. I hope you liked this Let's Play. Until next time, folks. Until then.